All right. That's me, but with the gun, you know. It's kind of similar. All right, this is a IM scrim on a Lakeside with our good brother Ghost. Looks like there's a very similar lineup to, I think, the team that beat them last season. Just our friend. Yep. All right. We're gonna start off checking the minigun. Good. Good. You're gonna be on default all around, it looks like. That's good. You're gonna cross left. That's good. A lot of times on Lakeside mids, I will try to decloak as aggressively as humanly possible when my team walks forward, but you guys are getting pretty good ground. I'd call for your team to start getting aggressive. This is okay, decloak. I would just shoot the heavy here, brother, because your goal on mids is to pretty much provide a distraction, especially if you can't get the kill. That's what a lot of Lakeside is, just distraction play, because it is such a wide open map. If that's not really your play style, your other option is just to play bathhouse. But from there, if you just decloaked and shot the heavy, your team probably would 100% won that mid, because four players probably would have turned around for you, and you definitely would have won. They're just kind of hanging out bath, that's fine. They're kind of capping. They know Met has Uber. I would not try to de- Okay, your scout's just gonna get a forest, it's fat. You're gonna try to go in sniper here, I think? Yeah, you should run away. They're 100% gonna know, yeah. If you walk on the point, there's no one there, you just gotta leave. Because someone's gonna 100% turn around. So I was actually ringing for, I think, an IM team yesterday, and I had one of my demo reviewees on my team, and the lack of comms from him was actually very, 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 surprising. So I just want to reiterate how important it is just to speak on the class. Just call everything you see. That was good. You got the flank. So Telly is a free frag here. You can camp it, whatever works for you. You should be looking for sniper, something to break the bath household right now. It'd be good. Yeah, sniper's in there. Yeah, you calm it. Thanks for that fat follow, brother. This is super suspicious. 100% know your spy. I think if you just kept walking into bath to get this the sniper, that would have been 100% better, because he lived for like 10, 15 more seconds than he needed to. But you're just gonna hang out bat as your team pushes point. That's fine. I hope you're calling them runes. I hope you're calling their percentage right now. Going here is bad. Yeah, you ran out of cloak though, so it was unfortunate. I probably would have just hung out on the bridge if anything. Since even if you did kind of want to, you don't really want to go on a team that's on runes. It's just not enough space. And if you st stood on bridge as well, you probably would have found the sniper, so that would have been a good call. A good check in the minigun again. I think there's a. I wasn't sure if there's a spy fucking camping you. This is a little messed up. I've got some floating funnies here. Are you gonna go behind point again? Nothing's happening though, so if they turn around, you just die for free. So, sometimes you die. But, like I said, you don't really want to try to go on their team unless something's happening. Because a lot of times they get these good bath households where it's hard for you to really do anything, and you want to be alive for when your team pressures. So that way you can get in during the chaos and potentially get a sniper demo pick, allowing your team to repush point. But yeah, they're just doing a standard bathhouse right side hold. Most important pick is the sniper. He is just on Razorback. You can just shoot him three times. Another good situation where Ambien and Enforcer are good. Yeah, shoot him. Almost. I'm surprised no one turned around, actually, even after you bumped into the engineer. It was kind of weird. But that was fun. If you do have trouble killing the sniper, like with the Razorback, try the Enforcer. It's pretty decent. or Ambi. You know, they're both actually still really good weapons for certain situations. So you should probably go into Runes or Bathhouse here. Your team is trying to push your left side point, so you need to get that sniper out of Bathhouse. Demo's fine here as well, should be free frag. There you go. Now you definitely want to go look for that sniper. Tell he's good. Okay, get that sniper, just shoot him. It's okay if you die. Good job. That's perfect. So a lot of times when you do hold Bathhouse, the best way to counter that is to walk left with your entire team and then just start pressing the left side of the point. Because the only thing that can really kill you in Bathhouse is the sniper. So, but your team looks like they're going to get a good Bathhouse hold here. So I usually like to hang out on runes when my team's doing this, so that way it can help defend against the enemies pushing from runes. Since there is, I think, four players on runes right now. So you're just going to go on them from bats, maybe. I think he heard sniper. It's a good call that he's on runes, by the way. Pyro knows. He's spy checking hard, so wait until your team calls they're pushing, then you can get going in. D-click on the dispenser is good, but the engineer's looking at you. I would just walk. I would have just walked to the sniper, to be honest there. No one else seemed to want to turn around for you, but regardless, it provided a pretty good distraction, and you guys were able to get the sniper and heavy off of that, so your team should be able to... Ooh, no, never mind. They do get the force out, so that's good, although they're probably going to get the recap, losing you guys around. Lakeside's kind of one of my least favorite maps. There's really only two playstyles for it, which is annoying gun spy like behind them, and... AFK and Bathhouse, so depending on the enemy team, you can choose. Because a lot of the time the Bathhouse playstyle is you kind of just sit in Bath and help your flank prevent the combo from getting in there. Going on Bathhouse early mid is actually really good because it gives your team early control. Your team should be pushing out into the runes to kill that sniper if you did call him because he was weak. I don't know, your team's just... Your flank's still not in Bathhouse, even after you guys basically won that, so that was kind of weird, to be honest. There's no reason that they should still be on their own runes. Going on Pyro's kind of risky here, but if he's distracted... Going on Soldier's good. Make sure you call Sniper, I'm sure you did, using your FOV. That would have been a good time to check percentage, by the way. Alright, get him. Yeah. Yo, Arbor Crypt, thanks for that fat follower, brother. I would just... Yeah, could you. Call Sniper's rotating runes. Probably just declick a little bit further back. Wait till he's focused. Yeah, this should be free. Wait for him to take another shot. Boom. Easy peasy. Job. This is Farmville. So I'd call for a sack now or something to go on their med, because you do want to force them out, and they do have point. If a soldier is bombing right now, it'd be 100% a drop. But unfortunately, he got trolled by backstab registration, so... Even just shooting the man is good there. A lot of the times during sacks, I will just decloak and start shooting. Because it will force players to turn around. I'm alright with baiting myself because I know my soldier is going to get work done 100% of the time. Sure, he called Sniper there. He's back on Razorback because he died once to a spy. Going on Soldier, NG is fine. And then shoot that Sniper. Yeah, shoot him. Alright, yeah, that was a good target. I probably would have focused on the Sniper there because I wouldn't have trusted my scout, but... It did work out for you in the end, so that was a good play by you. And you guys have Bathhouse again. I'd be telling my team to get in Bathhouse right now with our sniper. From here, you want to get yourself set up to whichever way they're going to rotate from. So it's going to be a little risky. That's unfortunate. Pablo, I don't review invite demos unless it's from other spies. That was a good spot. Actually, if you were there a little bit earlier, you probably would 100% been a medic drop or a medic kill. So that was good positioning on your part. Going on heavy is good here. He's definitely distracted, not going to turn around. Your Uber does get forced out, though. Probably didn't have to commit to that since you guys already had a terrible Uber. I think your med is gonna die maybe if the spy hits a single revolver shot. No, okay. But I like to play a lot with loadouts on this map actually. Sometimes I will just run Dead Ringer and just run around to be annoying. But you're doing pretty well with the Invis Watch, so definitely stick to it until they decide to counter you. I would have just shot the heavy here. Especially if your soldier was pressuring him, he would 100% died. You're right, I wouldn't deny demo reviews for demos either, probably actually. Only you, Poplar. This is a little risky. I was close. Hope you called Sniper Bath. Once again, just a reminder to call literally everything you see. Any information is good information, especially when your team doesn't calm. I'm calling snipers bad, soldiers just hanging out on point. This is, yeah. That's good, I'm glad you didn't commit to that. So, also here. Sometimes just waiting on this ledge is really good, because the sniper will eventually get antsy, or some player, probably the demo or sniper, will try to get a little aggressive here, and then you just jump on him and they die instantly. So, just another good spot to keep in mind. Jacob likes to camp this a lot. Like, if you probably just sat on that lip, they probably would have peeked it again, probably would have been a free sniper frag. Kelly's good here. You just gotta leave fast, because 100% someone's gonna rotate to you. This is a good decloak spot, although the engineer does see you. If I do hit the decloak in Bath, I usually try to either go from there or from the pillars. Those are good. Just somewhere as close to the combo as humanly possible, because otherwise someone's gonna eventually turn around. It's almost always just a suicide decloak, but sometimes it does work out in your favor. So they still have a really good Bath hold. To break it. Another good location, actually, just sitting on the side of the... There we go, right here is actually really good as well. Because eventually they do get aggressive on your runes, and it's just a free frag. So just consider that. Especially if you are trying to break a bathhouse hold. But that was good. The sniper overextended, you punished him. You have to be careful decloaking in the water here, as it does give you the water particle effect. But free demo frag. I mean, heavy, that's good. Man, he's pissed that you fucking killed him when he was overextending. Imagine being angry that a man punished you. This is kind of a risky decloak because they just had two spawners, but the player's an alien. Free frag, calling sniper main is good here. Yeah, you probably know he's gonna rotate bat, so it wouldn't be bad to camp it. Maybe not. Alright, he's gonna go back main. It did kind of look like he was gonna rotate bats from there. His spy called him there, so that's why he decided to turn around. His spy called you, I mean. Yeah, just shoot him. Good job. Alien down. So you guys will definitely hold this point for a bit longer. Basically, your job is just to hunt the sniper at this point. So powerful on this map. Of course, you're calling their runes. I'd like to see you look at the medic maybe once or twice. Sometimes if I'm ever really deep, by the way, I just disguise as the medic. And I just wait at the spawn, and sometimes the aliens will fall for it. If you ever want to have a little bit of fun, consider the fun disguises like that. Getting the Telian engineer is good here. Good going on combo. They use just anyone that's not flash is good, especially the heavy. Oop, soldier's gonna ring your disguise there, but they're not gonna stand on the point. That's good. Yeah, like, I was ringing for the IM Team EXA yesterday, and they didn't really hold Bath ever. It was kind of weird. So, it's good to see the red team. They kind of know what they're doing a little bit. Just decloaking and shooting the man, although the soldier did look at you. So, just another good example of be aware of your surroundings when you decloak. Like, almost do a full 360. It was good that you crouched, though. That's a good habit to be in. Another good habit as well, just to call here decloaking on. I'm sure I say this all the time, but just a simple going on combo, pressuring sniper is actually really important so your team can actually pressure off of you just decloaking. Because most of the time, if they are, you eat the air, unfortunate. It happens. I probably just go get Telly at this point, yeah. Engineer disguise is good. Drop. Easy peasy. Good job. Probably could have been two if you didn't pull your revolver out, but I'm never gonna tell a man not to shoot his gun. No, I got a match today at, I'm just not gonna stream it because it's being casted. It's just too much work for me. I'm just gonna stream the pregame and be done with it. Assuming they don't have ISP issues like yesterday. I mean, not yesterday, last weekend, or last Monday. Yeah, that is the cast link. I will give him the host though, beforehand. I don't think your soldier knows what he's whipping. Sniper's bath is good. Your soldier's with you, so just tapping the mini and shooting the main is really important. That's good. And your soldier should be able to get to you, hopefully. Unfortunate, but you did get the medics. I mean, the snipers, so. Your team should at least be trying to do something off of that. This is a good decloak spot. Although medic's looking at you, so it's not that good. Alright, I guess no one saw you. That was kind of weird, but. Yeah, if you hit all your shots there, sniper would 100% died. Happens, though. You can probably just shoot him again. Yeah, there you go, free frag. The man is no awareness. Soldier disguise, I think? Yeah, good. Get that medic, boy. I probably would have tried to get the health kit on my way there. I'm not sure if the medic got it, but I think someone else got it, and that was kind of bad for your demo. Regardless, that was really good. Yeah, I actually was just about to say that. Yeah, I guess he's gonna ring heavy for us, so make sure you get that changed with the cast. I actually just told XL to tell you, so. Snipers on bats, this is a good rotate. He's actually probably gonna drop off though soon. I'd imagine most snipers would be rotating their runes as their combos there. Sometimes, yeah, it looks like he's definitely mutant. Is he moving? Yeah, so he's on obelisk now. Right side point, bath. Oh, my good friend Yu-Yu TV, welcome, brother. You probably could have camped the enemy spy if you were feeling it, you know, just for a free frag. Well, I will consider it, brother. Get weird that spy spawning behind you. Good thing you didn't see him. Going on combos, good. You kind of made yourself a little suspicious there by not continuing the whole W and just like doing 80-80. I think if you just kept walking forward, you probably could have got the heavy and traded for that. Sometimes I also just turn around whenever I get detected. So it's kind of like, you know, because I'm sure he calls spy and you turning around is kind of like a reactionary call to that. So it can be kind of confusing to him. Just acting, just subtle things are important. They don't always work, obviously, but it's good to be in the habit. So you know they're going to be runes. You should probably be, you just heard sniper. You should be looking for sniper right here. You're definitely not going to get medic. Yeah. Because the sniper's isolated and the medic isn't, so it's definitely just safer to go for the sniper almost all the time in that situation, because I'm pretty sure you're just sitting on main. And do not steal the telly from your soul. Wow, what a nice guy. Yeah, the lip is good here. Probably just jumping over. There you go. It should be a free heavy. Nice. This is good, they're getting pressured hard. I think if he declicked a little earlier, he probably would have got medic, but demo's fine. Farm the engineer, he's an alien. Give him the engineer .tf treatment. Hell yeah. Nice one, gamer. Good gun usage. Alright, free frag on the heavy, didn't even turn around. Gonna start getting desperate here soon, so you want to try to set yourself up behind the combo because almost no one's gonna turn around when they start trying to rush point. Dying would be really bad here though, so it's not your fault though if you do run out of cloak, it's just unfortunate. Yeah, a lot of snipers, are very alien in the lower divs. They don't have very good spy awareness. Like that main team I ranked for yesterday, I could 100% predict every time when the spy was gonna be on me. And then my medic didn't heal me and I died. It was very unfortunate. But yeah, desperation mode begins. Just to distract or battle is good. And you guys get around. Good job. Alright, that was the first half, let's get to the second half. That was good. I'd just like to see you punish the sniper a little bit more for being isolated somewhere in main. And if you have trouble finding the sniper, just try to go somewhere that you think he's going to rotate. Usually if he's not with his combo and bath, he's going to be there soon. And when you play against snipers enough, you'll figure out where they end up like, where they like to rotate. Like, Boar is kind of hard to kill on this map, but I know where he likes to rotate a lot. So I'll just sit in places where he's going to rotate, and then he'll just come right to me. Where's my blue man? Oh, you're dead. Good chicken and the minigun. Sometimes I'll just check the sniper's loadout, too, so like, I can keep in my mind if he's on the Razorback or not. But calling him runes is good. You gotta be careful. Your team is fighting. T-clicking is good. Free soldier. I'd probably just leave. I wouldn't commit to the scout fight. But looking for snipers good here. Yeah, he's isolated. Get him. Nice job. Engineer baited you a little bit. That's a good reason why it's the call, you know, when you're declicking on a man. We have Fallen Lord on sniper. Going on med is good. Ooh, almost unfortunate. Ooh, you still get it. Good job. Yeah, that was a good decloak. No one turned around. You could have potentially walked to the health kit on bats and lived, but you never know. But you guys did win the mid off of you killing the sniper and getting bathhouse control, so that was a good job. Just try to coordinate with your flank as much as humanly possible in this map. That's what I try to do. I'll bait myself a lot for my flank. So Pyro's in spy chicken mode. So be careful. Probably be looking for sniper. Which is, I don't know where he is. Get caught out, it's unfortunate. So he did end up rotating two runes, so maybe if he waited a little longer, he probably would have killed him. But your team has ad. That's another good reason to call what Uber percenters are at. You should just be trying to fight them in bathhouse. I think you guys are playing really afraid because I think you guys think it's even. Well, it's definitely even now, so. But you've already lost a ton of players, so. That was kind of risky, but oh, I didn't get the health kit, unfortunate. Just practicing your, like, movement in cases like that can be really good. How you move a spy is very, very important. A lot of spy mains have good movement because a lot of the time they're just trying to finesse the enemy. Going for sniper is good here. Just gotta be careful of spawners. E-clicking tunnels good. Perfect. Free. Nice job. I would start calling for my team to start pressuring point and bathhouse. And then I would get ready to go once my team says they're pressuring. You just can't be hanging out here too long because there's definitely a spawner. Yeah, unfortunate. Personally, I don't like Cloak and Dagger on this map because it's so big and it's really hard to rotate to where the sniper is. I don't know if that's his reasoning, but I definitely need the extra mobility on this map. I really only use Cloak and Dagger if I'm playing off my comp or flank in bathhouse. I don't really like Cloak and Dagger in general, to be honest. It's kind of just not my kind of weapon. Another good spot, by the way. I use DR if the team is really passive and looking for me almost the entire game. So a lot of hyper-aware spy teams will almost always be turning around. Like BV's really passive, and that's when I run Dead Ringer, especially on this map. Almost the entire game, they're going to be on their side of the map, so it's just the safest watch for me to use. Just hanging out in this corner is really powerful because you can just decloak on the enemies that push into bath while they're fighting your flank, and it's almost always a free frag every time. So that's almost always where I play when I'm trying to help out my flank battle bath. Also, just taking the health kit from the enemies before they push in is really powerful as well. I almost always call when I take the health kit away from them because then I know my team has the advantage. That's a good frag on the soldier. You probably should have died there, to be honest, but you didn't, so that's good. Oop, another good reason to look around when you declick, because otherwise you probably could have just sat on the dispenser for an indefinite amount of time until they walked away. Just a good habit, just turn around. Get a view of your surroundings. Otherwise, the emphasis on bathhouse has been pretty good this game. That's why you guys are fucking rolling. Hey, get overtime. That's good. So now, basically, what you're looking for is anything that can help your team push point for overtime. So sniper's good. Although their combo is definitely going to be in there. Just sitting in between the pillars is really good. Yeah. I think if you just sat in the pillars for a bit longer, you probably would have got something. You probably felt a little rushed though, and that's okay. But your team's starting to push up now, so your opportunity was kind of missed. But going from bathhouse again is pretty good. Your team is down numbers. Yeah, I would have just say decloak there. Definitely would have got Pyro. How much health was that man at? Like 80. You probably could have just shot him too. But basically your team just needs to be running sacks or something. Just forcing out that Uber. So they can get... Because they just have to cap the point once. And you guys got a lot of time. So it's okay just to wait for the right picks before you push in. Getting hit by that flare is unfortunate. Not much you can do. Just the way it be. Another good reason to run Spicicle. You wouldn't have died there if you ran Spicicle. It's just the same old, same old. If I can't get into bathhouse, I almost always go for the telly. Between the pillars would be good here. Between the pillars, brother. The dispenser's bad. Because they're almost always going to be sitting inside of it. I think the Spicicle's bad, but the thing is I don't think you've played against a Pyro that actually is intelligent with their spy checking yet. It's definitely a side grade though, 100%. It's not better or worse, but it's definitely just as good. They both have their upsides and downsides. The only downside is obviously they can deny a stab if you, if the pirate is with the combo, but I usually don't go on the combo unless the pirate's away from them anyways or dead or distracted. It's a good declick on the soldier. Unfortunately, he decided to turn around. Do juke him though, get that health kit. Ooh. You beef the jump. If you didn't beef the jump, you would have lived 100%. But you guys are gonna get the mid, so it's good. It works out. It's just a rarity, like Yurok. It very rarely ever happens if you're playing intelligently. And a lot of the times, you can just swap off to the revolver and just shoot the man. And that's usually just enough to get a force or have one of your teammates coordinate with you. I just like living for that extra, 3 seconds. Declicking in tunnels good here. Sniper's a good disguise. Yeah, shooting the man is good. Good job. Like, the pirate was 72. I think I probably would have been able to kill that man 100% with this bicycle. Because I would have been immune to damnies. Just give him the two-shot.com. Especially because there's a mini sentry there, too, that died. You can just pick it up and get a full bicycle again. For like 6 seconds of immunity. I wouldn't peek bathhouse until the fire ran out, to be 100% honest with you. I think the demo knows you're there now, so it's kind of weird. But sniper is weak. You could probably go up and just 3-shot him. Got free demo. That's good too. Oh, Gert, speaking of working out, brother, I bought some fucking birthday cake protein powder, and it's really good. It's like a collab with Coldstone. I usually can't find fucking protein drinks I like, so it was a fucking godsend. It has sprinkles and shit too. It's very intelligent. Going on sniper is good here. Wait from the scope in. I would have just waited from the scope in, brother. Just be patient. Because he's just gonna wait until. Sorry, my bad. He's definitely not gonna turn around because he's not that intelligent. But once he scopes in, it makes a 3-shot 100% easier. Oh, that was a good one. Got two. He made something good out of a bad situation since he got discovered. They still do have full ad though, so hopefully do force him out of bathhouse. I got a mint chocolate chip one that I want to try too, but I tend to yeah, just capping the point is actually really powerful here. A lot of the times when no one is on the point, I will just decloak in this corner and start capping because cap time is really important on this map. Have I ever reviewed an engineer demo? No, I have not. I've only reviewed soldier, spy, demo man, sniper. Yeah, that's it. Free demo pick, good job. Yep, just killing the man is important. Calling sniperines, I'm sure. I mean, most of the time with engineer, just like positioning and capping the point and keeping your teleporter up. Especially on lakeside, you kind of just want to make sure you defend the runes, making sure the end enemy doesn't get on it, protecting your sniper, the like. Well, you kind of jump in the water a lot. You do kind of get water particles on you for a bit, but I guess no one's in bath. Bruh. Yeah, mine was like 25 bucks. Or like 30, I think, actually. 35, 30. For like a big jug. But yeah, 50 would be fucking expensive, dude. I mean, yeah, if you consider it, like, if you're drinking that for like breakfast or something, I think it definitely pays off. Because it'll probably last you like a month or more. Depending on how much you drink it. I don't know, I usually just get what's like cheap on Amazon. Or I just go to GMC, something like that. But you guys have the point. Going on math is okay. Just sitting in pillars good. Help your soldier. Get him. Max him, please. Alright, I'm surprised the heavy did not realize you were a spy there. I felt like he was shooting at you. Really, Exa? Because I feel like Nipnop's out of position like 100% of the time. So I feel like you could be telling the man, like, during this push, you definitely need to be helping your flank here. Like, in Lakeside, for example, you could say, you know, you just need to be staying alive on runes. You could probably be wrangling a mini-sentry from Bath right now, blah, 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 you know, just positioning stuff. It's 100% the most important part of Engineer. Usually do your protein powder with milk or water is my question. I know a few of them do milk. Gotta get the calcium, you know? Become Iron Man. Sap that mini, thank you. Minis are so goddamn powerful in overtime on this map. Yeah, just being annoying and making the enemy weak is good here. Yeah, milk is 100% the only way to go. I mean, if I'm desperate, I'll fucking do water, but milk is just the good shit. Your team should be able to hold this. Well, they couldn't, so they just gotta group up on left and get ready for another push. I mean, I think like the fucking protein shakes you make in the blender are the best ones. Alright, yeah, it was just a lot of, just try to coordinate with your flank members more. I don't really have your comms, so I'm not too sure if you call, like, who you're clicking on. Make sure you punish isolated snipers, rotate to where you think the sniper's gonna be, wait to let them come to you. Otherwise, it's good. Good job. And I'll make sure you get those comms out there, you know, seems good. But just work on those, that movement and declick spots in Bath probably a little more. Just try different spots, try the pillars. Jump around, you know, do all the fun stuff. Yeah, the fucking, god damn, what are they called? Blender bottles. Yeah, I actually just bought another one. Came with my protein drink.